kids. All aboard for I Love Toy Trains.
A duck walks into a drugstore and says, "Give me some chapstick and put it on my bill."
Thank you. Smoke is coming from the roof of the A-frame. The smell permeates the area. Now it has burst into fire. The smoke is heavier. There goes the fire alarm. The fire truck comes out of the station. Train Town Volunteer Fire Company number one. The truck rushes to the scene. It pours water on. The fire is struck.
From trees, we get logs. From logs, we get lumber. And with lumber, we build. First, the trees are cut into logs, and the logs are taken to a sawmill. This is an old-fashioned sawmill. It is powered by steam and makes a lot of noise. The big saw cuts the logs into boards, and the boards are used to build our homes. But we have to be careful not to cut down too many trees, because birds need trees to build their nests, and people need trees too.
Who's my favorite singer? Moodana. Lucille, give me a kiss. Hi, kids.
Oh, McDonald had a tree.
what's my favorite pie? Mooberry.
From the great Atlantic Ocean to the wide Pacific shore, from the green and growing mountain to the South Belt by the shore, she's mighty tall and handsome, known quite well by all. She's the regular combination, she's the Wabash Cannonball. Listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar, as she glides along the woodland to the hill and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear the lonesome hobo squall, riding through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball. Well, the eastern states are dandy, so the western people say. St. Louis to Chicago, Rock Island by the way. From the hills of Minnesota, where the rippling waters fall, no chances can be taken on the Wabash Cannonball. Oh, listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar, as she glides along the woodland to the hill and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear the lonesome hobo squall, riding through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball. Now here's to Daddy Claxton, may his name forever stand, and may he be remembered in the courts throughout the land. When his earthly race is over, let the curtains round him fall. We'll carry him home to victory on the Wabash Cannonball. Oh, listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar, as she glides along the woodland to the hill and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of the engine, hear the lonesome hobo squall, riding through the jungle on the Wabash Cannonball.
Oh, no!
Status check. The man on internal?
Affirmative.
Telemetry in launch condition?
Affirmative.
Missile in internal DC?
Affirmative.
Pressurization complete?
Affirmative.
T-minus 60 seconds and counting. Status check. Range safety arm light on.
Affirmative.
Range ready?
Ready.
Water system ready?
Affirmative.
I have a threat complete light. Lock tanking secured?
Lock tanking secured.
9, 8, 8. Ignition.
1, 4.
Main stage.
4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the show. I Love Toy Trains is one of the most popular children's series in the country. For a free catalog, call 1-800-892-2822.
Hi, kids. All aboard for I Love Toy Trains number 2.
Reporting car number 965. Rear truck box running hot.
with the track deck for inspection. If not okay, drop car and proceed according to previous orders.
Train number 101, Union Pacific Dreamliner, the city of San Francisco, for Omaha, Cheyenne, Green River, Austin, Salt Lake City, Sacramento, and San Francisco, leaving on track number 12. Aboard!
Did you ever wonder where food comes from? A lot of it comes from farms like this. Here's how farmers grow things. First, a field is plowed. Then a disc plow is used to break up the big clumps of dirt the plow leaves behind. Next, a field cultivator smooths out the field even more. The field is now ready for planting. April and May are good planting months. This farmer is bringing a wagon load of seed to put in his planting machine. It's fun to grow things. You should try it.
Santa Fe Super Chief, now ready and loading on track
horse. Why the line?
What my favorite snack is?
No, I don't.
Cheese and Quackers.
Number 28, Pennsylvania Broadway Limited. For Freshline, Pittsburgh, Altoona, Harrisburg, Philadelphia, Newark, and New York. Sleeping cars only. Leaving on track number 2.
Train number 22, the Rocket, now leaving San Francisco for Sacramento, Reno, Salt Lake City, Denver, Kansas City, Chicago, and Boise. Sleepy cars only. Last call. All passengers, please board at track 5. Over.
Kitchen, I know. Someone's in the kitchen with Dinah.
drumming on the old banjo. Fee-fi, fiddly-i-o, fee-fi, fiddly-i-o, fee-fi, fiddly-i-o, strumming on the old banjo.
Do you know what time I get up in the morning? No, I don't.
At the quack
of dawn.
train.
Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the show. I Love Toy Trains is one of the most popular children's series in the country. For a free catalog, call 1-800-892-2822.
Hi, kids. Welcome to I Love Toy Trains number 3. Logs you see between the rails are called ties. The gravel between the ties is called ballast. These men are putting down new rails, ties, and ballast.
Thank you. Look out, Kitty, here comes the train.
Called a mixed freight. A mixed freight has many different types of freight cars. There are hoppers, boxcars,
boxcars.
cars. This car carries automobiles and is called an automobile car. This car is called a gondola. And this is my favorite, the caboose. When I was younger, every freight train had a caboose. Nowadays, trains don't have cabooses. They have a blinking light on the last car. This blinking light is called an end of train device. I miss a caboose.
Ocean to the wide Pacific shore, from the green old Smoky Mountains to the Southland by the shore. She's mighty tall and handsome, and she's known quite well by all. She's a regular combination on the Wabash Cannonball.
Say, Mr. Duck, what happened to the duck jokes? They really quack me up. Speaking of quack-ups...
Trains and trucks work together to deliver things. These big trucks are called tractor trailers. They are also called 18-wheelers, semis, or big rigs. The part that hauls the cargo is called the trailer or van. Here are some of the machines that are used to load and unload the vans. This is called a MyJack crane. This thing with the long legs is a straddle loader. This big machine is a side loader. A long, long time ago, farmers plowed their fields like this. They rode a plow behind a team of horses. Around the turn of the century, farmers used tractors powered by steam. The steam tractors were big and noisy. By 1920, most tractors were powered by gasoline motors. This is a Farmall Super A tractor from around 1940. remember what the different types of freight cars are called? Okay, let's have a test. When the train stops, you name the car.
Tank car. Hopper. Boxcar. Gondola. I want a little milk. I want a little blue car. Caboose.
Very good. This is a horseshoe curve in Altoona, Pennsylvania. It's one of the best places in the world to watch trains because it's a busy main line and lots of trains pass every day. It is called Horseshoe Curve because it is shaped like a horseshoe. I like it when the engineer waves and blows the horn. And the people visiting wave too. Some long trains need an extra engine to climb the grade. These engines are called helpers. They help the train, just like you help clean up the kitchen.
We need jets.
Carry lots of grown-up folks and little kids inside. Is it bigger than our house? Well, how can I explain when my little boy asked me, Daddy, what's a train? When I was just a boy, living by the track, us kids would gather up the coal in a big old gunny sack. Then we heard the warning sound as the train pulled into view. The engineer had smiled and waved, she went rolling through. She blew so loud and clear, We had to cover up our ears, and we counted cars just as high as we could go. I can almost hear the steam and the big old driver scream with a sound my little boy will never know. Daddy, what's a train? Is it something I can ride? Does it carry lots of grown-up folks and little kids inside? Is it bigger than our house? Well, how can I explain when my little boy asked me, Daddy, what's a train? I guess the times have changed. Kids are different now. Some don't even seem to know that milk comes from a cow. My little boy can tell the names of all the baseball stars. I remember how he memorized the names on railroad cars. The Wabash and the TP, Lackawanna and the IC. Yeah, the nickel plate, the good old Santa Fe. Just names out of the past, I guess they're fading fast. Every time I hear my little boy say, Daddy, what's a train? Is it something I can ride? Does it carry lots of grown-up folks and little kids inside? Is it bigger than our house? Well, how can I explain when my little boy asked me, Daddy, what's a train? We climbed into the car, drove down into town, right up to the depot house, but no one was around. We searched the yard together for something I could show, but I knew there hadn't been a train for a dozen years or so. All the things I did when I was just a kid, how far away those old memories appear. I guess it's plain to see, but they still mean a lot to me, because my ambition was to be an engineer. Daddy, what's a train? Is it something I can ride? Does it carry lots of grown-up folks and little kids inside? Is it bigger than our house? Well, how can I explain when my little boy asked me, Daddy, what's a train?
Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the show. I Love Toy Trains is one of the most popular children's series in the country. For a free catalog, call 1-800-892-2822.
Do you remember your first electric train? Did you ride that train on fantastic imaginary trips to far-off places? Would you like to do that again with your kids? You can, you know, with MTH electric trains. At MTH, we make a tremendous variety of electric trains, from inexpensive starter sets to magnificent models of the world's biggest locomotives.
Use our toll-free 800 number or check the website to find one of over 800 MTH dealers nationwide.
The sound of that lickety-clack as they travel along down the railroad track.